Whilst all of this drama was unfolding on the dark railway, Ed and Sid were none the wiser, as they continued to assist the Castleman's Railway with their operations. However, things had changed considerably since the duo had arrived a few years back. Reconstruction of the line had been rapid, with the railway now extending another 2 miles or so to a small station near a country park. This led to a substantial increase in traffic, which was soon exhausting the two visiting engines greatly. Helpfully, some of the railway's own engines were now beginning to return to traffic, with the first, Robert, appearing just after the extension opened. Robert was, to say the least, a bizarre engine, as Ed and Sid discovered on the first night that he came to the sheds.
Good evening to you.
Hello there!
Hi.
So, you're the ones who have been running this line whilst I've been under restoration?
Yeah, we are. I'm Ed, and I'm Sid.
A pleasure to make your acquaintance. My name is Robert.
Nice to meet you, Robert.
Please, call me Rob. We're friends after all, are we not?
I guess so.
So, you're both ex-Midland Railway machines?
Not exactly. We were both built by the LMS, but to Midland Railway designs.
Ah, I see, I see. I myself am a thoroughbred Great Western Railway machine, through and through.
But hold on a moment. You're
a 3000 class heavy freight locomotive, drawn up and designed at Swindon Works, of course.
But you're not?
Don't be ridiculous, my boy. Of course I am. I wouldn't be painted in Great Western green otherwise, would I? I wouldn't have a safety valve bonnet, as is the tradition with Swindon-built machines, if I hadn't been built at Swindon.
Wait, I'm confused. You were built at Swindon?
Correct, my dear boy.
Then why do you look like a Great Central Railway engine?
Looks can be deceiving, can they not? But I assure you, I am a proper Great Western engine. I am. I am Great Western and proud. I am a Great Western engine. I am. Can't you see?
Yes, we see it. You're a Great Western engine.
Of course. Of course I am. That's what they told me. Built at Swindon. In 1914. Not rebuilt. No, 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 no.
Okay, then. So, now that we've established that you're most definitely, without a shadow of a doubt, 100% a Great Western engine, I assume that you're here to help us, right?
Huh? Oh. Yes, yes. The manager says that I'm taking the heavier trains so that you two can work on a rotor or something like that. He said another 2 engines were on their way too, but they won't be here for a few weeks. So we will have to manage until then. I'm sure we can do it with a bit of teamwork and coordination.
Haha, absolutely, mate. If that smoke box of yours is screwed on properly.
Well, it's very nice to meet you both. Owned by the railway too? Or are you from the supporting trust?
Neither. We're here on loan from the Dark Railway.
The Dark Railway? Can't say I've ever heard of it. What region is it? I assume the Midlands somewhere? Certainly not a Western Region branch line. Otherwise, I would know about it.
Southern, just like this line. But our line's in East Kent. But we both used to work on the Somerset and Dorset Joint Railway, so we're familiar with the old Castleman's Corkscrew.
Ah, excellent. then you both have decent route knowledge of the line. Well, I'm sure I will learn the ropes soon enough.
I'm sure you will.
Despite his strange tendency to think himself as a true Great Western engine, despite the fact that he clearly wasn't, Rob turned out to be a very friendly engine, soon winning Ed and Sid over with his work ethic and dedication to do good. His great strength meant that he could easily take the line's heaviest trains, leaving Ed and Sid to take the other services in turn. A couple of weeks went by before the railway's next engine arrived. When he saw the newest arrival in the yard one morning, Ed took a double take.
Eustace?
But it wasn't Eustace. As he shuffled over to have a better look, he noticed the engine had a different number and a different style of nameplate, which read Lundy. Ed introduced himself.
Hello there!
Lundy smiled.
Hiya.
Welcome to the Castleman's Railway. I'll be your host, Ed.
Nice to meet you, Ed. I'm Lundy.
Lundy? What a lovely name.
I'm named after an island, actually. Only a small island, but still.
I suppose they all worship you on this island, do they?
Ed had spoken before he had realised how rude this sounded, but Lundy just giggled.
Oh no, the island's uninhabited. Unless you count flocks of seagulls.
Both engines chuckled. So, you're the Castleman's newest recruit?
I am, and it'll be really nice to make some new friends here. It's been so long since I've seen another engine. Not since the scrapyards.
She faltered for a moment. Ed looked pained. I'm so sorry.
It's okay. What matters now is that I can meet other engines again. And what a place to do so. I remember this railway.
Ah, another engine who's worked here previously.
Oh yes. I used to run diversionary expresses to Bournemouth along this line when engineering works were carried out on the main. But I don't recall seeing many Fowler 4Fs coming down this way.
I'm a Somerset and Dorset joint railway boy. Only came down this way a couple of times.
Oh, really? I never got up to the old S&D. Shame it was closed.
It was a shame. Me and my best friend ran away from there though, and we somehow ended up getting preserved.
Well done you. So you live here now then?
Sadly not. I'm here on loan until enough engines are operating to run the service again. Then, me and Sid are going home.
Oh.
Lundy looked quite upset at this. Don't worry, it won't be for a while yet, I don't think.
Oh, that's alright then.
So, you've been under restoration then?
Yeah,
But a voice interrupted her.
Come on then, Ed. Aren't you supposed to be working the next train?
I'll catch you later, Lundy.
I hope so.
With that, Ed steamed away, leaving Lundy to continue raising steam. Soon, Lundy had met Rob and Sid, and she got on well with both of them too. Like Rob, she was powerful enough to handle the bigger trains, and worked in rota with Rob on these services. Things were going well, until the next engine arrived. The engine's name was Harry, and he was an ex-Southeastern and Chatham Railway tender engine. He got on well enough with Lundy, and to an extent, Rob. But the little engine seemed to take a disliking to the two Midland region engines, especially Ed. On his first night there, he refused to speak to them, despite them attempting to give him a warm welcome. Ed had decided to give the newcomer a wide berth, so as to avoid any potential arguments. The last thing he wanted was to cause any trouble. Such was his respect for the Castleman's Railway and its staff. However, one misty morning, things came to a head whilst Ed was shunting, he had a long rake of coaches that he was preparing for Lundy's first train, but didn't realise that Harry happened to be at the other end of the platform, also shunting. Due to the mist, Ed didn't realise that they were on the same line, and by the time he did, it was too late to avoid a collision. He braked hard, but bumped into Harry's tender, causing the little engine to cry out in surprise.
Oh, the bloody hell was that?
Sorry, Harry, I couldn't see you in the mist. Harry moved forwards, then backed into the adjoining platform so that he could speak to Ed.
For God's sake, can you watch where you're going? Bloody Midlands, haven't you ever shunted coaches before? It's not hard.
I said I was sorry, jeez! It was an accident, fella.
Right, listen very closely. I don't care if it was an accident, a deliberate act of sabotage, or invading Russia in the winter. You stay the hell away from me and keep your other pal away from me too. The sooner you two piss off back to your own railway, the better. We have enough engines to cover us now, even if one of them is complete fruitcake.
Ed could feel his temper rising, but resisted the urge to shout at Harry. He responded calmly. Look, Harry, I don't want to cause any problems.
Then why don't you just bloody leave then?
Well, I...
Well?
I'm here to help the railway, until it gets back on its feet.
The railway is back on its feet now, we don't need your assistance anymore.
That's up to the railway to decide. We're staying here until everyone is certain that you lot are up to running the service.
I don't think you're up to running anything, quite frankly, after that little stunt. Why would we want to keep you anyway? What if you do something similar and cause an accident with those bloody cheese graters for brakes? And where are you going?
I'm not having this discussion with you, mate. Ed moved forwards, but Harry was quicker. He puffed straight up to the points and blocked Ed's progression.
Listen here, I'm not done with you yet.
Harry, come on. Don't be like this, dude.
I'll behave however I damn well like. This is my railway, it is not yours, you are a guest here, and if you don't do what I tell you to, then...
Are you threatening me?
Not a threat, I promise. You and your little friend better shove off and leave me to keep this line in order. Otherwise, you'll bloody well regret it. Do I make myself quite crystal clear?
Ed didn't reply.
Well then, do I?
Just get out of my way, Harry. I've got elsewhere to be. Harry did indeed begin to move out of the way. But as Ed moved forwards ahead of him, Harry lurched forwards and shunted hard into Ed's tender. Ow!
Disrespect me again, and you'll get more than just a hit to the buffers, old friend.
And with that, Harry backed away towards the other end of the station, leaving Ed slightly shaken. Later that afternoon, Ed made his way back to the shed at Ringwood, where Sid was simmering, waiting to take over from him. He could tell that something was wrong with his best friend, as Ed slunk into the shed next to him. Ed? Yes, Sid. You don't look too good. What's happened? Nothing. Don't bullshit me, Ed. You look terrible. Thanks, mate. I know I do. You know what I mean. Something's wrong. Tell me. Ed sighed. All right. I had a bit of a skirmish with that Harry bloke this morning after a little shunting accident. He was trying to goad me into an argument by insulting me and telling me to leave his railway. His railway? He's only been here 5 minutes. We've been here longer than he has. Who helped rebuild the damn railway? If anything, we're more appropriate for this railway than he is. We actually worked on this line back in the day. Ex-Southeastern and Chatham locos rarely came up here anyway. So he can go royally fuck himself on that count. Well, don't say anything, Sid. I don't want to add fuel to the flames. Sid looked curiously at Ed. That's unlike you. You love a good argument. I usually do, but I don't want any trouble. I just want to do my bit to help the railway out. That's what we're here for. At this moment, they heard a whistle nearby, as Lundy left with her next train to Holmesley. Sid put two and two together, as Ed remained silent as he watched her go.
Oh, I see what's really going on here. Huh? You're not really interested in the preservation of this railway. You just want to get into Lundy's ashpan. Fuck off, Sid. Well, is it true or not? Of course it isn't. I'm not just a one-trick pony, you know. I can like girls without wanting to bang them immediately. Uh-huh. I'll believe that when I see it. But that's besides the point, Sid. I don't want any fuss. I'm just going to keep my smoke box down and get on with it. But you can't let bullies just walk all over you. Or in this case, bullies. Funny. Funny man. You've got to stand up for yourself, Ed. Don't let him just push you around. But it was technically my fault this morning. I don't care if you instigated it or not. You can't let him get the better of you. If he does it again, fucking spark him out. I couldn't do that. That's what he did to that Johnson free effort Wells that one time. He literally called you a bastard son of a whore, Sid. What else was I supposed to do? Exactly. Fine. I couldn't do that again. Well, if you're not going to do anything about it, then I will. Come on, Sid, just drop it. Just keep calm and ignore him. For me? Alright, I will. This time. But I'll be speaking to Mr. Knight about this. Oh, please, Sid, don't get the manager involved. If he does it again, I will. Alright, fine. But just keep out of his way. If he doesn't interact with us, he can't bully us, can he? He won't bully me. Trust me. But Sid was wrong. Harry did indeed try to antagonise Sid. But unlike with Ed, Harry discovered that Sid wasn't about to back down from an argument. You fucking what, mate?
I'm telling you, you're not welcome on these metals.
Dude, me and Ed literally worked along here in the 50s. Never saw your ugly mug around these parts.
Ugly mug indeed. Takes one to know one.
Smart mouth there. All gob and no gut, though.
Ah, a threat from a little compound. A little failed experiment. I could take you in a fight any day of the week.
I'm a rebuilt 2P, actually, you blind bastard.
So you're so bloody well unreliable there to rebuild you, how sad.
Listen here, you jumped up little injector sucker. But Ed had approached as Sid spoke. I told you not to let him get the better of you.
Listen, I've been around long enough to have a name, you know.
Quiet, you! Come on, Sid. Leave it. He's not worth it.
And you can shut up and all. I thought I told you to leave this place, yet here you are.
I already told you, Harry. We're here until the services...
I could care fucking well less. Both of you better get out of here before I do something I really fucking regret.
Fucking try it! Come on then, boy! Try me! Sid, please, come on! Ed backed away, as Sid slowly followed. You better stay out of our way and all, Harold!
You're not my friend, you do not have the privilege of calling me that.
Yeah, fuck you too.
Ed gave Sid a proper dressing down once they got back to the shed, where Rob was stood, trying to mind his own business. I told you not to do that. He started it. Of course he did. He's looking for a fight. Don't give him what he wants. He'll only make our lives miserable if you do. It'll give the manager an excuse to kick our tenders back to Kent. And we're supposed to be keeping a low profile and doing our bit. We can't very well do that if we keep giving in to Harry's tactics.
You know, I had a similar problem to yours long ago. We had a bully in our yard, but you know what we did? We just ignored him, held our smoke boxes high, and carried on regardless. Why, I'm a Great Western, and—
Shut the fuck up!
Sorry.
This is the final straw. I'm going to Mr. Knight.
There, Ed. He's only looking out for you, you know.
I know, but I don't want to have to leave just because one engine hates my tubes.
Take care. Harry's an introverted sort. Just seems a tad grouchy.
But he's not picking on you, is he?
I won't let him. Being a grand, great Western locomotive such as myself, I will not entertain the idea of being bullied by another. I simply will not allow it. You have the right attitude, Ed. Don't let him get to you. But Sid is right in his own way also. Speaking to Mr. Knight might go some way in resolving the issue.
I suppose so. But what if it gets worse?
Then the most pragmatic thing might be to return home. I know that isn't exactly what you want. But if it prevents any more arguments, then perhaps that would be for the better. Not that I nor Lundy would like that, of course. We have become quite fond of you two. It would be a shame to lose such versatile engines.
Ed didn't respond to this. He didn't want to have to leave, but he didn't want to continue being picked on by Harry. Confused and conflicted, he could only wait and see what Sid could achieve with his chat with the manager. He's a nasty piece of work, sir, and I want his harassment of myself and Ed stopped.
Well, this is a most unfortunate turn of events, Sid. I'm really sorry that this has happened on our railway. We tried to promote equality and a union above all else, and to hear that our visitors are being mistreated by one of our own engines? Well, I will see to it that Harry is spoken to regarding his attitude. Rest assured.
It better be, because if he does it again, I won't be happy.
Of course, understandable. Thank you for coming to see me, Sid. I imagine it has been difficult for you in this situation.
It isn't me that's having the hard time. I'm doing this for Ed, because he doesn't want to have to go home just because of a stuck-up little, so-and-so.
Understood. I will speak to him and get this resolved.
Cheers. Whatever Mr. Knight had said to Harry, it seemed to have done the trick, for the time being. Rather than start an argument with Ed or Sid, Harry simply ignored them, deciding to sleep elsewhere on the line, rather than in the main sheds. Ed was relieved, as was Sid. See, Ed? Speaking to management has solved your little issue. Things are going great again. Yeah, it really is. I do feel a little bad for Harry, though, having to sleep in places other than here. Fuck him is what I say. Oh. Lundy had just backed into the sheds next to Ed. She didn't look very happy. What's wrong, Lundy?
Oh, Harry's been aggravating me again.
What's he done?
Telling me that I'm stupid for associating with you two. And Rob.
I will reiterate, fuck him! I'd rather not thank you. He's definitely not my type.
I don't know. I just wish everyone would get along.
So do I.
I know you've been trying, Ed, and it's appreciated. And so is everything that you and Sid have done for the railway. Even though Harry cannot see it, myself, Rob, and the railway can. And we value your efforts to help us set up our new home. Thank you.
That's alright. If you're happy, then I'm happy. Ugh! Get a room!
Is he alright?
Yeah, he's just very protective of me. We've been friends for so long, he hates seeing me so down. He'd do anything for me.
That's so sweet.
And I'd do anything for him. We've been through so much together. Escaping from the S&D. Losing our friend Mac up in Scotland. Losing Liz. Ed stopped speaking for a moment, thinking about the untimely death of his first true crush. Lundy sighed.
It's difficult losing a loved one. I lost my boyfriend of 7 years to the scrappers. I had to listen as they cut him up right behind me. I couldn't bear it.
I'm so sorry for your loss, Lundy.
I'll be alright. Time heals all wounds eventually. What's important is that we find new friendships and value what we have now.
Truer words were never spoken.
I'm glad that we were saved, at least. As far as I know, none of my brothers and sisters survived the cutter's touch.
But they did! Two of them live on our railway! Lundy perked up.
Really? You're not just saying that, are you?
Would I lie to you during such a serious conversation? Two of your brothers live on the dark railway with us, 257 Squadron and Sir Eustace Missenden.
Thank the heavens, I'm not alone. After all, I was so worried that I was alone in preservation.
And now you know that you're not.
Oh, that's amazing. That means that perhaps one day I could come and visit you on your railway too. And meet my brothers, of course.
Oh, that would be great. I'll definitely mention it to my owner once I get home. And once you have more engines operating here, I'm sure it can be arranged.
I hope so. That would be wonderful.
Lundy continued to simmer happily at this prospect, whilst Ed smiled to himself, grateful to have made at least one meaningful friendship whilst at the Castleman's Railway. Things went smoothly over the next couple of weeks. Harry kept his mouth shut, and Sid did the same. However, one bright morning, Ed was taking on water in the yard, getting ready for his next train. As he waited for his fireman to finish, Harry rolled up to him, looking angry.
Oh, for God's sake, can you get out of the bloody way? I need my water now!
I'll be done in a minute.
I mean, it's too long. Get on with it!
Come on, Harry. I thought we were over this now.
Over this? This? You ratted me out to the manager. You've taken over this railway and scrap iron mate of yours. None of my colleagues respect me now because you poisoned their bloody well minds. I get no respect. It's all your fault.
Harry shot forwards, pushing Ed backwards several feet, severing the water hose in the process.
Oh, look what you made me do!
I...
Now that is a broken water column on your conscience now. You'll bloody well pay for that.
He went to move towards Ed again, but Ed winced and moved further away. Harry laughed gleefully.
You see now the superiority of me? You are weak, pathetic, and a thorn in the side of this railway. You and that friend should have been turned into baked bean cans when you had the chance.
Unfortunately for Harry, Sid, Lundy and Rob were all nearby and heard this heated exchange as Ed continued to whimper. Sid was enraged as Harry rolled back and away from Ed. Without warning, he shot forward and slammed into Harry. Surprising everybody in the yard, Sid shunted Harry further and further back until finally Harry's tender fell into the turntable well. He shook with fear as Sid advanced on him. You bastard! You dare speak to Ed like that? I warned you, Harold! Think you're a big man, huh? Want to be in charge, do you? Think you're superior to us? Well, look where you are now! In a turntable well! Not so big and tough now, are you? I'll fucking kill you! Sid backed up, and was just about to run full pelt at Harry again, but Lundy intervened, rallying the duty shunter to quickly couple them together. Sid screeched. Get off me, Lundy! He's crossed the line now! I'll fucking have him, I will! If anyone should have been scrapped, it's this little piece of shit!
Calm down, Sid.
But Sid was too enraged to listen to sense. Even with her brakes fully on, and despite pulling back as hard as she could, Lundy could barely hold Sid back as he continued to shout at a very shaken Harry. Get off me! He's getting what's coming to him! Let go of me! Let me pummel this twat to kingdom come!
Rob, help me. Help me!
Rob had already rolled forwards and was coupling up. It took the combined strength of both Lundy and Rob to finally pull Sid away from Harry, shocking even Ed. Sid continued to rage as Harry looked on in sheer terror at what had happened to him. "They can't hold me forever, Harold. Think you've got what it takes to take me on? Huh? Punk? Just you wait! Just you wait!" Services were suspended for the rest of that day. Ed and Sid were escorted away from the scene, whilst Lundy and Rob assisted with the recovery of Harry from the turntable pit. It took a long time, but eventually, the little tender engine was re-railed and brought back into the sheds. Lundy and Rob both abandoned him as soon as they could, instead opting to reside in the carriage sheds for the remainder of the day. The next day, Mr. Knight spoke to Ed and Sid.
"Good morning, you two."
"What's good about it? We've blown it now, haven't we?"
"I've spoken to Harry and I have reprimanded him for his abhorrent behaviour yesterday. I told him he deserved to have been shunted into that pit. However..."
He turned to Sid.
"I do appreciate that tempers ran high yesterday, Sid. But you know that you crossed a line, don't you?"
"I know I did, but I don't care either. That Harry insulted us one too many times, and the way he treated Ed yesterday, well, I snapped. I couldn't help it. What would you have done if your best friend of 50 years was suffering that kind of abuse? You'd act as well."
"Perhaps not so violently as you did, Sid."
Sid merely glared as Mr. Knight continued.
"I do not appoint any blame on you, Ed, but you must understand that this arrangement cannot continue like this. Not right now. Emotions are running too high, and I'm afraid that I will have to arrange for you both to go home."
Ed looked sadly at the rails beneath him. The very rails that he and Sid had helped to relay. The rails that he and Sid had run on for several years, trying to be of assistance to this quaint little railway. Now, he was being asked to leave the line that he had helped to kickstart back to life, and leave the new friends he had made. Sid, however, continued to scowl at the manager.
"However, you are both welcome back in the future, and I very much hope that you do so once things have calmed down, and perhaps once Harry has ended his current boiler ticket. I very much appreciate everything that you have done for us, and..."
"No."
I'm sorry?"
"No."
"No? What?"
"No, we will not be coming back. I have seen many things in my life, but the blatant disrespect I see here is astonishing. If anything, Harry should be sent away, not us. He's bullied Ed almost into submission, he's mouthed off at me and the others, and he's proven that he doesn't have any regard for anybody else. Yet, he's allowed to stay here. I guess it's easier to just let him get away with it whilst you send us back home. Frankly, I am ashamed of you, Mr. Knight. We came here with the best of intentions, wanting to do our best to get the railway operating, boost its profile, and get things started before your own engines arrived. But now, I feel that you've done us a great disservice and have let Ed down greatly. It's all well and good saying that you've reprimanded Harry, but you've punished Ed for trying to be a good engine. And on that note, we're leaving."
"Sid..."
"No! You want us to go? We'll go, as soon as you've got a lorry sorted out for both of us. Good day to you!" Mr. Knight looked pained as Sid led Ed away. Two days later, Mr. Knight had arranged for two lorries to take Ed and Sid back home, both due to arrive later in the afternoon. Lundy came over to them to see them off.
"Well, I guess this is goodbye for now."
"I suppose it is. I'm really sorry for the trouble we caused."
"Don't be silly. It's not either of your faults. Trust me. If I had my own way, Harry would have left. not you two.
Still, would have been nice to stay longer.
It would have, but I promise you, I'll come and visit you on the Dark Railway when I get the chance.
Promise?
Promise.
I can't even... Ugh, so gross!
You are funny, Sid.
Chub.
Until next time, good luck, guys.
Thanks, Lundy. Cheers, I guess. Lundy departed to take her train, leaving Ed and Sid to wait for their lifts home. However, Sid had spotted Harry in the sheds nearby and called out to him. Happy now, Harold! You've got your wish! We're leaving, and we ain't coming back! Harry looked like he was on the verge of smirking, until Sid shot him down. Listen here, you little creep. Ed cares very much about this railway. And Lundy. I suggest that you leave her alone, keep the railway running without issue, and keep your big mouth shut. Otherwise, I'll break my promise and come back here, and I'll personally see to it that you're damaged enough to be scrapped. Do I make myself clear, shitbag? Harry cowered in fear at these words, but did not respond, satisfying Sid. I don't think he'll cause any more trouble. Yeah, I hope not. It was soon time for the two engines to depart. Rob came over to shunt them towards the lorries, being deliberately slow so that he could say his farewells.
I am most disappointed to see that you are both leaving. It won't be the same around here without my Midland pals. I'm going to miss you two.
We're going to miss you too, Rob. Thank you, Rob. I hope everything will be okay around here.
I'm certain it will be. Myself and Lundy will keep Harry in check. It is a great shame that he couldn't just accept you two for who you are. That's not the Great Western Way at all.
It certainly isn't. Well, goodbye, Rob. Yeah, thanks for everything.
And the same to you both. I hope that we meet again one day.
Ed and Sid said nothing as they were shunted away from the station for the last time. Both of them looking forward to going home, but equally lamenting the fact that they may never see the Castleman's Railway again.